Jackson County Sheriff Mike Winters was elected to his position in 2002. From there, he would serve three consecutive terms, his third scheduled to end this year. During Winters' campaign for a second term in 2006, now Medford Police Chief Tim George ran against Winters, but the Jackson County Sheriff's Employee Union threw their support behind George, not the sheriff.
Give me the phone calls, because we didn't have that prior to the election. We didn't have a lot of complaints, and so I think it was a little closer than I expected.
In 2007, Winters had a showdown in court with the Medford Mail Tribune over releasing a list of concealed weapons license holders. The Mail Tribune said it was a public records issue, but Winters fought to keep the list private.
You know, I truly believe that people's information in this area should be protected, and I'm willing to take a stand.
A Jackson County Circuit Court judge sided with the Mail Tribune. Also in 2007, Winters denied a gun license to a medical marijuana cardholder, arguing that federal law prohibits anyone with a controlled substance to have a concealed weapons permit. In 2008, a Jackson County judge ruled the sheriff must renew the medical marijuana patient's gun license. Winters appealed the decision, lost, then appealed the case again to the Oregon Supreme Court. He lost that appeal too. The legal battle cost taxpayers more than $30,000. Then in 2011, allegations surfaced regarding abuses at the Jackson County Jail. The American Civil Liberties Union interviewed hundreds of inmates.
There are definitely problems at the jail.
Settlements were issued in a number of cases alleging inmate abuse. At the time, the sheriff's office would not supply records to us and refused an interview. Eventually, Sheriff Winters told us that settling a case is not an admission of guilt.
The facility is operated within accordance with state law. The policies are followed. And there's no other issues that we're going to really discuss.
According to records, the county spent at least $93,000 litigating cases against the Jackson County Jail. More money was spent in 2011 when an ex-sheriff's deputy won a $200,000 lawsuit against the county after he says Winters fired him for arresting a former JCSO deputy and giving an Oregon State Senator a speeding ticket. According to our research, that lawsuit cost county taxpayers more than $479,000. Alone. The county paid out at least $600,000 to fight just these legal battles. Then getting a lot of attention in 2012, a convicted bank robber escaped the jail by leaping from the roof onto a since-removed tree, calling into question their security.
The bottom line is we own this.
The man was found about a year later by U.S. Marshals. In his time as sheriff, Winters has also been outspoken about his opposition to stricter gun control laws.
One thing that I can promise to the residents of Jackson County, that the federal government is not going to come and seize one gun out of this county as long as I'm sheriff here.
And the number of jail beds increased this year during a jail expansion, and the sheriff's office relocated to a brand new facility on Crater Lake Highway. The sheriff's office also installed a new security system at Shady Cove Elementary that turns on cameras inside the school during an emergency. Mike Winters' time as sheriff over the past 12 years marked by both accomplishment and controversy. So far in the race for Jackson County Sheriff, Ashland Police Deputy Chief Corey Falls, a candidate for the position, has received more than six times the amount of financial contributions that Winters has received.